As of 2005, the RDA for potassium is 4.7 grams, and less than 2% of Americans hit those numbers. Less than 2%. I think it's safe to say that in America, in the US for sure, we definitely have a problem with a lack of dietary intake of potassium. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Dustin Williams, and for the best health, nutrition, and fitness advice, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit that little notification bell so that you're notified when I post a new video every week. Low potassium can be really hard to test for. The reason being is that 98% of potassium lives in the cells in our body and not in our blood. So whenever we're pulling blood levels of potassium, we're only seeing around 2% of the actual potassium that's in our body. Potassium is very tightly regulated. Your blood potassium will typically only show low whenever your entire body is deficient in potassium. And we definitely don't want to get to that point. So knowing this, it makes it really important for two different factors. One, to pay attention to the symptoms and signs of potential low potassium. And two, to make sure that you're actually getting enough potassium in your diet. Potassium as a mineral is an electrolyte. Many people are familiar with electrolytes, and there are about 7 electrolytes in total. But there are 3 main electrolytes that most people are the most familiar with. This is potassium, sodium, and chloride. And to make things easier, when I talk about sodium and chloride, I'll just say salt, because sodium and chloride together is what makes salt. Low levels of potassium can definitely cause some problems. One of the first things that it can lead to is high blood pressure. A lot of times whenever people have high blood pressure, one of the first things that they look towards is their salt. Here's the thing about salt, is salt is typically only going to be a problem if you do not get enough potassium. When you are low in potassium and high in salt, it can lead to high blood pressure. Making sure that you're getting enough potassium can definitely help potentially eliminate any high blood pressure issues. The second thing that it can lead to is less insulin secretion. So potassium specifically plays into the secretion of insulin. And if you don't get enough potassium, it could potentially lead into higher levels of blood sugar. The third thing is swelling or edema. If you ever went out and you've had some cheat meals or things that were really high in sodium and you end up swelling, like your fingers swell, part of the issue is due to sodium, yes, but mostly it's due to the sodium-potassium ratio. If you find that you have enough potassium in your diet in relationship to the sodium, you will find that you will not swell as much or at all. So being able to get enough potassium can definitely play into swelling and edema. The fourth thing is a potentially increased acid load in the body. Having too much acid from this could potentially lead into things like osteoporosis as well as kidney stones. The fifth thing is that it will affect bowel movements. The main one being constipation. Not enough potassium can lead to constipation. Number 6 is headaches. If you've ever heard of taking cream of tartar for headaches, the reason being is cream of tartar is loaded down with potassium, and if you have a deficiency in potassium, it can lead to headaches. So making sure that you're getting enough potassium on the regular can help eliminate potential headaches. The next one is the one that most people are familiar with. This is muscle spasms and cramps. Lack of potassium can lead to that. I'm sure that you've heard, if you've been having cramps, to eat a banana. There can be some truth in that. Not getting enough potassium can have an effect on that. You can find that low levels of potassium can also lead to a slower heart rate. And then there are also some more serious conditions that can definitely warrant some immediate medical attention. Now, knowing that all of these symptoms could be potentially signs of low potassium, the other question could be, what might cause you to have low potassium? Of course, not getting enough potassium in your diet is a big one, and I will discuss some of the things that we can do on that here in just a minute. The other things that we need to pay attention to are diuretics. If you're on any type of diuretic, which is also really common, if you're on blood pressure medication, you can have a diuretic. This could lead to lower levels of potassium in the blood. Another thing is drinking too much water. People are so focused on dehydration, which is something we definitely need to pay attention to, that we completely tend to overlook overhydration. And whenever we drink too much water, it tends to flush out some of the electrolytes in our system. And whenever getting enough potassium is already potentially a problem, we definitely don't want to flush out any of the potassium that we have, and we want to hang on to what we've got. So make sure that you are not overhydrating and drinking too much water. Also, vomiting and diarrhea. So at any point in time, if you are sick or if you're bulimic, these things can lead to an immediate loss of potassium as well. So knowing these things, it starts to lead into, how can we fix the problem? How can we make sure that we are getting enough potassium from our diet? And the first thing, of course, is making sure that you're getting enough from your food. This is always the first step that I have people take. And the easiest way to do that is to track your food and use an app that uses and tracks micronutrients for you so that you don't have to do all the work. I've already done a video on this. I will link to the description below. If you click the link, it'll take you to the video and it'll explain exactly how to use an app that does everything for you to track your entire vitamin and mineral intake so that you can start seeing on a day-to-day basis based on your current diet how much potassium you're actually getting. When you're looking at your diet, one of the easiest ways to get more potassium is to increase fruits and vegetables. These are typically loaded down with potassium. Now, I'm sure most of you are familiar with bananas. It's kind of the staple food whenever it comes to increasing potassium, but there are a lot of other foods that have just as much, if not more potassium than what's contained in a banana. You have things like sweet potatoes and white potatoes, which are loaded down. You've got orange juice, you've got coconut water, spinach, just to name a few things that are really high in potassium. Also, another thing to pay attention to is when you are cooking your vegetables, the juice that comes from the vegetables is where a lot of the potassium ends up going. So every time that you cook veggies, if you end up discarding the juice, you're discarding a decent portion of the potassium. So using this to create some sort of a broth or a soup can also be very beneficial whenever you're looking to increase levels of potassium from your diet. Another thing to pay attention to are the lean portions of meat, eggs, and dairy. And I put the emphasis on the lean. Not to say that you need to avoid fat, but the leaner these are, the meat, eggs, and dairy, the more potassium they are typically gonna have. So let me give you an example. If we take milk, we take skim milk and full fat milk and we compare the two. And if we match them calorie for calorie, we take 200 calories worth of skim and 200 calories worth of full fat. And we look at the potassium levels within each one. The skim milk has about 915 milligrams of potassium and the full fat milk has about 430 milligrams of potassium. So that's over a 50% drop for the exact same amount of calories and the potassium that you're getting by choosing the leaner portion of the dairy. There's also a great nutrient search tool online that's completely free. It's nutritiondata.com, and I will link below in the description so that you can click and go directly to that website. As I said, it's completely free. It's great. You can go in there, and if there's a certain mineral you're looking for, so if it's potassium or calcium or magnesium, whatever it is that you're wanting to try to get more of, you can put that mineral in there, and then you can have it display what foods have the most of that. And what's even better about this website is you can go in and start to break down specifically if you were trying to do a low-fat diet, you know, what are the things that are higher in carbs and lower in fat that contain potassium, or vice versa? What's something that's higher in fat and lower in carbohydrates that also contains potassium? So you can really break it down for your specific needs, and it'll list out everything that you would need that's gonna have those minerals in it. So it's a great resource and completely free. And of course, you can supplement with potassium. Here's the thing about supplementing with potassium. It's a little bit tricky, and I typically recommend this as a last resort whenever it comes to getting more potassium. I recommend that you focus first on the food aspect, look into the medications that we talked about. That's where I would spend my first focus first, and then from there, if you wanted to add in a supplement, you could go that direction. The FDA has actually regulated it where only one serving is allowed 99 milligrams of potassium. Now, if we're looking at 4,700 milligrams in a day, 99 milligrams doesn't make up much. There is a small portion of the population that cannot properly excrete any excess potassium, and this is the reason why they have put a limit on it. The majority of people can handle more potassium than that, but this is one of those things that you want to gauge. If you do want a supplement, I would recommend that you use a powder instead of a pill and that you actually sprinkle it on your food and take it with your food so that it's more evenly applied whenever you're taking the potassium. If you want to supplement with it, again, I would recommend that you look to your food sources first. But if you do want to supplement with it, I'll put a link in the description below to the one that I would recommend. So as you can see, potassium is a very important mineral that we need to make sure that we are getting enough of in your diet. I hope this video helped you out. If you are looking to join a community of people that are looking to get healthier and understand health and fitness and nutrition a little bit better, because it can definitely sometimes be a tricky space, I've created a free Facebook group that I would love it if you guys join. All you got to do is click the link below in the description, ask to join, and we're posting stuff, answering questions, doing anything that we can to help you out to get you pushed in the right direction whenever it comes to being healthier. And of course, if you liked this video, I would appreciate it if you would smash that like button and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys in the next video.